could look to make that move pretty soon, though. They do still have their lasso available again, so I could look to jump and pull people out of position away from that tower. Yes, it's increasing. It's just increasing more and more for Secret, that PL. The Deepunk guy's well farming a crazy amount, and you mentioned a little bit of luck for the Viper to get that door ball. We didn't find out, but it was an Impclaw picked up for the Kunkka, one of the better pickups for him, and now he has a full BKB on top. So he's having a little bit of problems if he gets caught inside of a pit or caught by the Willow. Now, how do you bring down this man?
This game is just sort of falling into the same way that we've seen Secret take the other two games that they did this series, where they've been able to push EG into a position where EG feel that they're forced to play the farm game. But the truth of the matter is, their heroes, they just do not farm as well as Secret's do. So they're sort of, they're just playing a losing game at the moment.
Yeah, and Drow is not going to be getting stronger at this point versus a Pio. Because if you look at Arteezy's itemization, he's feeling like he actually has to go for a BKB in this game because of the ways they have to get on top of him in the backlines, be it from the Tiny, be it from the Batrider, be it from just a charge from the Phantom Lancer. He's feeling it very threatened.
I mean, and like Arbed's Viper, you know, Viper just isn't the hero that he used to be when it comes to AFK farming. You're seeing that in his net worth. You just see right behind him, both Zai and Poppy, they're nearly as farmed as EG's mid.
Yeah. He's 0-8, a place that you never really want to be on Viper. You want to be the one leading the charge, trying to set up the walking up, being unkillable, but in this matchup, you're very killable because the way that Secret's set up so far. And we're seeing very deep aggressive wards coming out too. Puppy puts one down bottom to be able to watch any movements that come out down there. If they see anything there, like the transition, then they can look to pressure onto that mid tower or even top.
It really is just another one of those games where you've sort of got to ask yourself, what is the plan from EG? It's not going great right now, and what are they sort of trying to work towards? In their minds, where do they see an opportunity to turn this one around?
Because it looks, it's the same, it feels similar to the last one, that they don't have someone to initiate and start to fight.
He's got a full heart, you know, Matsu, he has a full heart. You are not killing this man, he's level 20.
Oh, yeah. And he also picks up a Mindbreaker for himself, too. Alright, man, this is a scary Phantom Lancer. He also has some neutrons they can pass off to his buddies as well, since he's been jungling for quite a while.
And it really just feel like, you know, off the back of the drafts, as we said, both of these Strouts sort of going back to what we saw previously in the tournament. EG, they chose to go with this Drow Viper, but Secret, the PL, that really was the hero that was just having the edge in a lot of these situations.
Back to see our TV, the coming in.
He's going to try and slide away, but with Matsu on top of him, there's no hope for the Drow Ranger. That's EG's carry done and dusted. A Secret can just play the map however they wish with the lead that they have.
Yeah, look at this, they're collapsing already. They find the Train Protector Fly. They don't have any fear. They're not afraid of this Aguilar. They're not afraid of this Willow. They're not afraid of anything on EG.
And they don't need to be. EG, they have nothing right now to scare Secret with. Their cores remain incredibly under-farmed. And Secret, they're taking over the map. They're taking over the entire game. The next thing you know, you're going to look at Matumaran and he's going to have the Basher. He's going to have the Abyssal Blade. And these sort of item progressions cannot be matched by EG in this passive state that they're playing.
No, I mean, EG's draft is all about usually you get the ball rolling, you group up, and you kind of just start going. Secret's draft kind of thwarts that, especially when they have this type of a lead. And I don't know, I'm not too sure what you even can do versus EG, because you don't want to give up this Roche. If you do, that's going to be almost impossible for you to come back. So they're trying to contest it here. They have the Underlord, which is really good around the pit, at least.
It's not going to be an easy fight, though. Already the illusion is just burning the entirety of Ramsey's mana. He's going to have to use the shrine right now to start things off, just to get his mana back up. But instantly, you know, the constant onslaught of these illusions pushing them. They're going to burn it again.
Super difficult, and now they're not only just behind, they're massively behind versus a PL who I don't know how they can bring down at all. They can't seem to kill anybody on their lineup. When they get a nice root into fear play, everybody else just gets away, and they're almost full health right after the fight.
And off to Roche they go, nothing. It's going to be there from EG's assault this. As you said, they kind of had to, but there's a lot of things that EG needed to do this game, and they were unable to achieve any of them.
They're trying to farm up this BKB, like we mentioned, for Arteezy. Also, trying to finish up a maelstrom for Abed. But that was Abed with his BKB reveal in that last fight, and it did absolutely nothing.
Here we have, they are trying to TP up once again, but it's too late.
Roshan has fallen much too high for the ages. The little was needs Manisha, who falls back to safety out of the range of the multi-shot. With that initial burst fire attempt from EG, they haven't got anything else left to throw out. They've got to back off. A secret now with this Aegis. I mean, they couldn't even kill Matsu the once, killing him twice. It's pretty much impossible. His farm is now nearly 7k ahead of Arteezy's Drow. There is no stopping this man. And a secret, they've done an incredible job of just securing a map. And when they do that, Matsu and Nisha, they just get out of control.
Yeah. And there's so limited plays that EG can really do. I feel like I'm just repeating myself over and over again, but I don't know what they can really do versus this lineup because of how fast an advantage Secret claimed. From the rotations, from Yapsor. And they just parked themselves in all three lanes. And it doesn't feel like there's anything that EG can do.
At the moment, you just look at the heroes, and EG, they have one core hero, the Drow, and a core hero that's severely under farm. Both the Viper, Abed, and Ramsey's Underlord, they're falling behind. They're falling behind the supports of Secret. Their game, it's over. I mean, as you said, their game was over long, long ago. It's now to Secret to just decide when they want to end this. They move up, there is a repair kit for EG.
I think back here, you know, right, you accept that, you're like, alright, you got a repair kit and tree armor, we're gonna back up and at least claim these secondary outposts, so you can't have it crit. What if he wants to try to make a solo playground design? You say we're gonna do it?
He can, or he absorbs in, gives right the back of his knees, they'll secure the bounty ring.
They don't defend at least the outpost for his team for the time being, so they get a little bit of experience, but that experience does not do anything. I mean, Matsu, he's just poking here alone. He's got Aegis. He's got no fear at all.
He is invincible.
Isha makes his way over, a full AC now as well, on top of that, on the Coco. And they can just go from tower to tower. They've got aggressive wards now too. Zai, trying to look for a catch, and he's going to find it.
And they got dragged by Ramsey's in there on the jump. Ramsey's sitting silent, but no trouble. He can't be blocked by Ahmed. He's running away. They're chasing him down. Past the tier 3, past the tier 4. As Secret continues to bully EG closer and closer to submission.
More repair kits still available. Fine. We'll throw one more out. They have one additional one after this. In combination with the glyph.
I mean, what EG's done to themselves this game, it's beyond repair. These kits aren't going to do anything to help them out in this sort of situation. In they go.